Greetings, my fellow IDD subscribers. Today we talk about non-specific lower back pain. This part of lower back pain has often been incorrectly diagnosed. With non-specific lower back pain, X-ray are of no value. MRI are of little value. They are not diagnostic. In the last 25 years, medicine has made great improvements in the diagnosis of non-specific lower back pain. And particularly, two tests have been used, provocative discography and dual diagnostic blocks. Please note, I am not a spinal specialist, I'm not a medical doctor, so I'm just going to explain this as best as I can. So the first test, provocative discography, is where the surgeon would inject, or the spinal specialist would inject one disc at a time. So they would inject one disc at a time. So they would maybe inject in this one, how are you doing? No problem. Next one, how are you doing? Oh, I'm very sore. Next one, no problem. Next one, no problem. The doctor knows that this is the problem. So that one provoked pain. When afterwards, the doctor would then do a CT scan of that disc. Now, a normal looking disc inside looks like that. But one that has been injured looks like that. So that is internal disc disruption. That is an early tear within the disc. The next test, which is dual diagnostic blocks, is not to aggravate the pain, but to remove the pain. So like your dentist would give you an injection to take the pain away, this is similar. So it's two local anaesthetic injections. So what the doctor would do would inject into the SI joint and ask you, how are you doing? After a little while, to give the anaesthetic a chance, how are you doing? No, still sore. Then they would maybe inject into the facet joint. How are you doing after giving a little bit of time? Now I'm still sore, sir. Doctor, next injection, how are you doing? Doctor, the pain's gone. Now the doctor knows that that is the one. But 2 hours later, the pain comes back, and he does the second injection, which is the dual, into that. And this is, this time, the first one was lidocaine, this time it's bupivacaine. And the lidocaine took it away for, say, 2 hours, the bupivacaine, as it goes in and as it starts to work, it will take the pain away for 6 to 8 hours. But you're using very small amounts of anesthetic in both injections. Then the doctor knows where the pain is coming from. So these two tests have been able for us to work out non-specific back pain as 40% coming from the discs, 30% from the facet joints, and 20% from the SI joints. The next talk I'm going to give will be on why I call it the paradigm of internal disc disruption. Thank you for listening.